As an advanced medical practitioner and pharmacist practicing in family medicine, excessive sweating, medically known as hyperhidrosis, is a very common problem that many of my patients have. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 7 of my very best tips that are scientifically backed that help with excessive sweating, medically known as hyperhidrosis. So let's begin. Diving straight into tip number 1, we're going to go through the natural remedies to begin with. Diet can play a very big role in how much we sweat. Spicy foods contain something called capsaicin. Capsaicin is very well known for making our body temperature rise and make us more sweaty. Fatty foods and high calorie foods, they require a lot of energy for the breakdown of them. This in turn raises our metabolic rate, which raises our temperature, which again causes more sweating. Now on the flip side, fruits, vegetables, lean proteins help maintain a stable temperature. And this is all by helping aid the body's natural thermoregulatory process. Additionally, antioxidants also in these foods help reduce inflammation and our overall skin health. So this keeps your sweat glands functioning properly without excessive sweating. Tip number 2, again, keeping it natural. Hydration is key, guys. It really helps with that thermoregulation. And the problem is being dehydrated basically makes it much harder for our body to regulate our temperature, causing us to sweat much more. Your sweat glands rely on a balance of water and electrolytes in order to function properly. So when you're hydrated, your body is able to regulate your temperature and sweat glands properly. And additionally, one thing that a lot of people don't talk about is when you're hydrated, your skin is also healthy. This helps support the skin's natural barrier against sweating and irritation. Tip number 3, again, keeping it natural. Dress for success, guys. The fabrics you wear can have a significant impact on the amount you sweat. Breathable fabrics like cotton, bamboo cotton, wool, merino wool, they allow air to circulate and not allow that heat to build up like synthetic fabrics do. And the science shows that the more that your skin can breathe, the less that your body needs to sweat in order to control temperature. And by the way, whilst we're talking about clothes, our SweatBlock products, they are transfer resistant. So it basically means you're not gonna get that typical antiperspirant staining that you get on your black shirts, your blue, your green shirts, whatever color they are. That way you can feel confident all day long. Tip number 4, let's talk about stress. Again, keeping it natural before we go into treatments. So here's the thing about stress. It triggers our sympathetic nervous system, otherwise known as our fight or flight response. When you experience stress, you release adrenaline, you release cortisol. This fight or flight response, it all basically raises our temperature, raises our heartbeat, and all of this causes sweat. On the other hand, when we're nice and relaxed, our parasympathetic nervous system kicks in and our heart rate is lower, we're cooler, we're not sweating as much. So here's what you need to do. If you've got a very stressful lifestyle, you've got to try breathing techniques, go for a walk. That can always bring down those adrenaline and cortisol levels and release those feel-good endorphins. Do exercise, do yoga, do meditation. All of these are great at just relaxing us down and lowering our body temperature so we're not sweating as much. So now moving straight on to tip number 5. We've done all the natural things to help us sweat less. Now we're going to talk about treatments. The number one thing that I recommend all of my patients who've got excessive sweating, hyperhidrosis, is a clinical strength antiperspirant. Now, when I'm talking about clinical strength antiperspirants, I'm genuinely talking about things that contain aluminium chloride, okay? For example, our SweatBlock maximum protection wipes or our SweatBlock roll-on, okay? These two both contain a very potent aluminium salt known as aluminium chloride. You only need to apply it once a week, so once every 7 days, and the effects last up to 7 days. Aluminium chloride is always best applied at nighttime. That's why I always recommend my patients. So let's say you use it once every Sunday night, let's say for example. So make sure when you're using aluminium chloride, because it's very strong, and also basically the more potent the aluminium salt is, so aluminium chloride, the more likely there is for sensitivity. So always, always use it on dry, clean skin. If there's any hair under your armpits or wherever you're applying it, try and trim down those hairs as well, so it's getting directly on the skin. That way it's going to plug those sweat glands and stop you from sweating. aluminium chloride and these strong antiperspirants are always my number one recommendation for patients. Genuinely speaking, 9 out of 10 patients is the first thing I go for, and I cannot recommend it enough. One other pro tip I'd say as well, I forgot to mention it when I was talking about application, make sure you're applying aluminium chloride on dry skin. Make sure it's not wet with water. If you have sensitivity and the skin is wet, it pretty much doubles, triples the intensity of the sensitivity. So applying on super dry skin and super clean skin, it's always recommended to do a patch test as well before using any aluminium containing antiperspirant or any product in general, to be honest. And straight on to tip number 6, let's talk about correct application. We've spoke about it a little, but I'm just going to summarize a little again. Now, I remember once I recommended a patient to use an aluminium chloride antiperspirant at nighttime. And when I reviewed them and followed them up after a couple of weeks, they didn't really notice much difference. So I examined their armpits because I was main place they were sweating from, and I noticed they had a lot of underarm hair that was really long actually. So the first thing I asked them to do was to trim down their underarm hair, because if the area of skin isn't hairless, basically if there's too much hair there, it's not going to get to the skin. The way these aluminium antiperspirants basically work, these aluminium salt antiperspirants work, is they basically plug the sweat glands and stop them from sweating. Okay, that's how these antiperspirants work. So if you've got lots of hair there, it's like a barrier basically. It's not going to get to the skin and it's not going to be effective. So make sure you trim the hairs down, it's clean, and again, it's dry, like I said, to reduce sensitivity. Moving straight on to tip number 7, I want you to become a bit of a pro when it comes to antiperspirants and the aluminium salt. So we've spoke a lot about aluminium chloride. That's what's contained in the SweatBlock wipes and the SweatBlock roll-on. This is the most potent aluminium salt, and obviously we use it once a week. But the real question is, what about daily antiperspirants? Do they contain aluminium chloride? Well, not usually, no. So for example, if we look at our SweatBlock, the antiperspirant and deodorant that we have here, it contains aluminium zirconium tetrachlorohydrex GLY. So this one is more like the deodorant or antiperspirant sticks that you see and probably use already, that you put under the armpits. But again, the aluminium salt in it is less potent, so we can use it daily. And if you're wondering, can I use it in combination with aluminium chloride? Yes, you can. You can use the aluminium chloride, so the stronger ones, basically the more potent aluminium salt, you can use that once a week. And in the mornings, you can use the SweatBlock antiperspirant and deodorant. Basically, this has got the less potent aluminium salt, so it can be used daily in combination with that once a week. So I really hope you found this information helpful, and it really helped with the sweating. If you know anyone who will find this information helpful, please do share it with them as well. SweatBlock really is a game changer when it comes to excessive sweating. As a US-based company, we offer FDA-approved products for excessive sweating. Our journey started in 2004 when Dr. Scott Steffensen, a renowned researcher, developed the original SweatBlock wipes basically to help with his own excessive sweating. And today, SweatBlock is the number one clinical strength antiperspirant sold online, helping hundreds and thousands of people regain confidence. Visit our website or Amazon to learn more about our full product range. I will leave a link in the description below. And as we always say at the end of every single week's video, SweatBlock, sweat less, live more.